Hello everyone, welcome back to the pharmacology practicals. The next practical which we are going to consider is the effect of drugs on the rabbit. So the aim of the experiment is to study the effects of drugs on the rabbit. The requirements of the experiment are as follows. The animal used is the rabbit, weighing in between 2 to 5 kgs. The solutions which we are going to test today, that is the drug which we are going to test, are the acetylcholine, physostigmine, ephedrine, atropine and saline. Equipment required is the rabbit holder to hold the rabbit, torch and a cotton pick. Now, coming to the principle of the experiment, the effects of drugs on the eye, they can be very well established. Okay, the local actions. Now, there are certain drugs which can act systemically to have the effect on the eye. Okay, so something which is given systemically that can even affect the eye. But there are certain local actions of a number of drugs which can be tested without even administering the drug systemically. Just by instilling the drug into the eye in the form of maybe the eye drops, or application of the drugs in the form of eye ointments. By this also we can elicit the number of local actions of drugs on the eye. Now, before going into how exactly these drugs are acting in the eye, let us brief about the types of muscles which are present in the eye. Okay, so these are of two types. Okay, so this include a circular muscle. Now, why it is known as a circular muscle is because it is placed circularly. So this is the pupil of the eye, and this is the iris. Okay, so there are two types of muscles which are present in the iris. That is, one muscle is placed circularly, that is known as sphincter pupillae. This is the one, okay, which is placed circularly. Now, these muscles, they have parasympathetic supply. Okay, so parasympathetic system, which is a division of the autonomic nervous system. So, this parasympathetic system, it is supplying to these sphincter pupillae. So, as you can see, ACH is written over here. So, acetylcholine is the main neurotransmitter at the parasympathetic system. So, obviously, acetylcholine can affect this sphincter pupillae. So, it contains cholinergic muscarinic type of receptors on this sphincter pupillae or the circular muscles. Okay, to which exactly the acetylcholine will bind, drugs like acetylcholine or carbachol. They can bind to this muscarinic receptor and they will contract this circular muscles or sphincter pupillae. So, as a result of contraction of the circular muscles, what will happen? Contraction of sphincter pupillae here, muscarinic agonist. Okay, so drugs like acetylcholine, they will contract the circular muscles and it will result in decrease in the pupil size. So, this pupil, which is the opening, okay, so it will be reduced, and this particular phenomenon, it is known as meiosis. Okay, so any drug which can stimulate this muscarinic receptor or stimulate the parasympathetic system, it can result in meiosis. It will decrease the pupil size. Then the next type of muscle which is present in the iris is the dilator pupillae, or it is also known as radial muscle. That's because it is placed radially. You can see this, it is placed radially, right? So that's why it is known as a radial muscle. The name of this type of muscle is dilator pupillae. Now, these muscles are supplied by the sympathetic system. Here you can see that it is supplied by the sympathetic system. So the transmitter over here will be noradrenaline or norepinephrine. And the type of receptors which are located in this type of muscle is alpha adrenergic receptors. Adrenergic receptors are of two types, alpha and beta. So basically alpha receptors are present on this dilator pupillae. So any drug like say ephedrine, it can bind to this adrenergic receptor, stimulate them and result in contraction of this dilator pupillae. So as a result of contraction of this dilator pupillae, what will happen? The radial muscle have contracted. So what will happen? The pupil size, it will increase, and this phenomenon, it is known as mydriasis. Okay. Now, how do you check the effects of drugs? So what are those different parameters which are checked? Okay, once the drug is applied, what are those different changes which can take place in the eye which you can measure? Firstly, any drug which is instilled in the eye, it may change the conjunctival congestion or pupillary size or the light reflex. Light reflex is when a light is thrown onto the eye or it is focused onto the eye, what happens to the pupil size? It decreases, right? Miosis will be produced in order to reduce the amount of light which is entering your eye. And exactly opposite happens when you move into a dark room. What happens? Your pupil size increases to gather more and more light. So then more and more light can enter, and after some time you will also be able to see in the dark, right? Okay. Then corneal sensitivity or the corneal reflex, this can be checked. Okay, that is once you touch your cornea, obviously what happens? Your eye starts blinking automatically, right? So that's a corneal reflex. Or intraocular pressure can also be changed. Now, in this particular experiment, these are the three parameters which we are going to check: the pupillary size, the light reflex, and the corneal reflex. So pupillary size, how you can check this pupillary size? By placing a transparent plastic scale in front of the eye as close as possible, and you can measure the pupil size. Exact size measurement may not be required. You just have to observe whether the pupil size has increased or whether it has decreased after the instillation of your drug. Next is the light reflex. So this can be easily checked by focusing the light, torch, light of the torch in front of the pupil. So if you focus the light towards the pupil of the eye, obviously if light reflex is present, what will happen to the pupil size? It will decrease. And once you remove the light source, obviously the pupil size will come back to normal. Okay. Next is corneal reflex. Okay, so corneal reflex means the touch reflex. So if you touch the cornea with the help of a cotton swab stick, okay, so cotton wick may be used over here. So you need to check the cornea gently, okay, with this cotton stick from the side. Don't try to touch it from the front. Okay, from the side you should gently apply the cotton stick. So if the corneal reflex is present, it will, the animal will start blinking the eyelids. Okay, so this is how these three parameters are checked. Now let us see how exactly our drugs are acting and what are the types of effects which can be produced by the drugs under study. So the first drug which we will consider is the acetylcholine. So acetylcholine, it binds to the muscarinic receptor which are located on the sphincter pupillae. Okay, so acetylcholine, it will bind on the sphincter pupillae to the muscarinic receptor on the iris. So as a result of this, what will happen? It can stimulate the receptor. So sphincter pupillae will contract and it will result in miosis. Then next drug is physostigmine. So physostigmine, it is a reversible inhibitor of the cholinesterase enzyme involved in the destruction of the acetylcholine. So as a result of inhibition of this enzyme, the metabolism of acetylcholine will be inhibited. As a result of this, there will be increase in the concentration of acetylcholine, which in turn will go and bind to the sphincter pupillae, muscarinic receptors. So anticholinesterases, that is physostigmine, when it acts, it will inhibit the metabolism of acetylcholine, and in turn acetylcholine concentration will increase, and this acetylcholine will go and bind to the circular muscle or the sphincter pupillae, which will contract and it will result in the same effect, that is meiosis, without producing the loss of light and the corneal reflex. So it is maintained. Next drug is ephedrine. Now ephedrine, it is an adrenergic drug. So it can bind to the alpha receptors which are present on the dilator pupillae or the radial muscles in the iris. So as a result of this, it will contract the dilator pupillae. So what will happen? As a result of contraction of these dilator pupillae, the pupil size will increase. So mydriasis will be produced without any effect on the light and corneal reflex. So light and the corneal reflex will be maintained. Only thing is, it is increasing the pupil size. Next drug is atropine. So atropine, it is a competitive antagonist of acetylcholine at the muscarinic receptor. So it is just a blocker. It will bind to the muscarinic receptors which are present on this sphincter pupillae, but it will not have any effect. It will not stimulate the receptors. So what will happen? It will prevent the action of endogenously released acetylcholine. It will block the action of acetylcholine on these receptors. So as a result of this, it will result in paralysis of the sphincter pupillae. The circular muscles will be paralyzed. So because of this, it will result in the mydriasis. That is, here the muscles have totally relaxed. As a result, relaxation of the sphincter pupillae because of the anti-muscarinic drug, it has resulted in the increase in the pupil size. That is, mydriasis will be produced. Now, this paralysis of sphincter pupillae, it results in the loss of light reflex. Okay, so they will not be able to respond towards the light reflex. So when you focus the torch light onto the eye, these sphincter pupillae, these are totally paralyzed, right? So they won't be able to contract. Okay, when light is focused onto the pupil, more light is focused onto the pupil, the sphincter pupillae contract, right, to decrease this pupil size. But that is not happening because the sphincter pupillae has been paralyzed. So as a result of this, the light reflex is lost as a result of action of the atropine. But the corneal reflex, that is the touch reflex, it is retained. Now, coming to the procedure of this experiment, first step is to place the rabbit in the rabbit holder, keeping its head outside. Okay, so rabbit holder, it will enclose the entire animal and only the head will be focused outside the rabbit holder. So it becomes easy to test the drugs in the eye of the animal. Okay, so it's very important to restrain the rabbit. Okay, now for this you need to acclimatize the animal to stay inside the rabbit holder before performing this particular experiment. And for each drug you need to use a separate rabbit. You cannot test the multiple drugs in the same animal because the effect of the drug will last for quite a long time. Okay, so you just can't wait for your drug to be metabolized and removed out of the body. So you need to use new rabbit for each drug. Okay, so first step is to place the rabbit in the rabbit holder, keeping the head outside. Next is observe the size of the pupil in both the eyes. Okay, so you need to measure it with the help of the scale and observe what is the pupil size. Third step is to examine the light reflex. So we are checking all the three parameters. Now, light reflex, how you can check? By focusing the light of the torch in front of the eye and moving the light to and fro. That is, you have to move the torch towards the eye. It will result in decrease in the pupil size. When you take the light away from the eye, the pupil size will come back to normal size. So this you have to do 2-3 times to check whether the light reflex is present. Next step is to examine the corneal reflex by touching the side of the eye with the help of a cotton wick. Now, once you check all the parameters, okay, next step is to instill the drug into the eye. Now, out of the two eyes, the right eye of the rabbit will serve as the test. So you are going to instill your drug in the right eye. Okay, so instill a few drops of this acetylcholine in the conjunctiva of the right eye of the rabbit, which will serve as the test. And similarly, instill saline in the left eye. So this left eye will serve as a control for all the rabbits which you are using. So in the first rabbit, we have instilled acetylcholine. Now, once you administer the drug, wait for 10 minutes. Okay, so 10 minutes time you are going to allow your drug to act. So after instillation, after 10 minutes of instillation of the drug, record all the three parameters: pupillary size, light reflex, and the corneal reflex. What we have done in the second, third, and the fourth step. Okay, now similarly, repeat the same experiment with the remaining drugs, that is ephedrine, physostigmine, and atropine. And in for each drug, you need to use a new rabbit. Okay, so in each rabbit, the right eye will serve as a test and the left eye will serve as the control in which you are going to instill the saline. Now we shall see the exact experiment with the help of a video on the Excology series. Okay, we'll have a demonstration. So this is the first rabbit which we have selected. So as we have seen that the right eye of the drug is being used as a control in this situation and the left eye is being used as a treatment eye. Okay, so in the control eye we are instilling the saline. So as you can see that saline, it does not produce any change in the pupil size. Okay, so now let us select the first drug. Now over here in the software, acetylcholine is not available, but instead we will use carbachol. Okay, so it has been instilled. Now imagine that this is an acetylcholine. So what has happened? It is also a cholinergic agonist, just like acetylcholine. So what has happened to the pupil size? You can see the difference. Okay, as compared to control, the pupil size has reduced. Okay, now let us see the light reflex. So when I'm moving the torch towards the eye, the pupil size is decreasing, right? It is producing meiosis. When I move it away, again it is coming back to normal. Now let us see what is happening to the test eye. Okay, here again the light reflex is present. The pupil size is decreasing, whereas it is coming back to normal. Okay, it is already constricted, okay, because of the effect of drug. But still it is showing the light reflex. Now let us see the corneal reflex. So when I touch the eye, it is blinking the eye, right? So corneal reflex is present. Same is the case with the test eye. Now let us check with the next drug. Okay, so I've used a new rabbit, instilled saline in the control eye. Now I'm using the next drug, that is physostigmine. Okay, now can you see the difference? There is decrease in the pupil size. So physostigmine has resulted in meiosis because it potentiates the action of acetylcholine. Now let us check the light reflex. So it is present in the control and it is also present in the test eye. Similarly, touch reflex or the corneal reflex is present in control as well as in the test eye. Now let us check the next drug. So I have selected a new rabbit, instilling the saline in the control eye, and I am administering the ephedrine in the test. Now have you noticed what has happened to the pupil size? It has increased, right? So it has resulted in midriasis because it has contracted the dilated pupil. Now let us see the light reflex. It is present in the control and in the test also it is present. As I am moving towards it, it is decreasing the pupil size. The corneal reflex, it is present in the right as well as in the left eye, the test eye. Now let us check the next drug. I am instilling saline in the control eye and the next drug is atropine. Okay, so it has resulted in the increase in the pupil size. So it has resulted in midriasis because it is acting as a blocker for the muscarinic receptor, so it has produced the opposite effect to that of acetylcholine, that is midriasis because of the paralysis of the circular muscles or the sphincter pupil. And the light reflex, it is present in the control eye in which we have instilled the saline, but it has resulted in loss of the light reflex in the test eye because atropine results in paralysis of the sphincter pupillae as well as the ciliary muscles, so it does not show the light reflex. So there is loss of light reflex. But the corneal reflex, it is present in both the eyes. So this is the observation table. So we have tabulated all the results which we have observed with the different drugs. So as you can see, with the ephedrine, the first parameter, that is pupil size, it has resulted in increase in the pupil size in the test, whereas there is no change in the control eye. Light reflex is present in both the eyes and corneal reflex is also present in both the eyes. Acetylcholine, it has resulted in meiosis, that is decrease in the pupil size, whereas there is no change in the saline treated eye. And light reflex is retained as well as corneal reflex is also retained, it is present. Physostigmine, again it potentiates the action of acetylcholine, so similar type of action will be seen, that is decrease in the pupil size. Or meiosis, in control there is no change in the pupil size, whereas the light reflex as well as the corneal reflex are present in both the eyes. With atropine, it is a muscarinic blocker, so it will block the action of acetylcholine and it results in the paralysis of the sphincter pupillae, so pupil size will be increased, whereas it has resulted in loss of the light reflex, so light reflex is absent in the test eye, whereas corneal reflex is present in both the eyes. So from this we can infer that saline does not produce any change in the pupil size and retains the light as well as corneal reflex. Ephedrine, it produces mydriasis, that is increase in the pupil size and retains the light as well as corneal reflex. Acetylcholine, it produces meiosis and retains the light as well as corneal reflex. Physostigmine, similarly, it produces meiosis and retains the light as well as corneal reflex. And atropine, it produces mydriasis, retains the corneal reflex, but it produces the loss of light reflex. These are the references. Thank you.